Throughout this conference, there'll be numerous presentations promoting the future possibilities of pest management throughout Australasia and the world. With advancements in techniques, technologies, and new management principles, we will hopefully be better equipped to address some of the impacts that introduced species pose to our environments, economies, and society in general. A point should be made, though, that whilst these possibilities are exciting and have likely been stringently assessed during their research and development phases, without effective means and being able to monitor these new approaches' impacts in the wider landscape, we as land managers fall short of implementing best practice pest management. Monitoring seems to be the long forgotten step in implementing adaptive management, particularly in the context of on-ground application of pest management. Whether monitoring is put into the too hard basket or there is a fear of the actual answer is up for debate. If the definition of insanity is doing the same thing repeatedly, expecting a different result, what do we define repeatedly undertaking actions without ever knowing the result? Too often in pest management, the measure of success comes from the kill sheet or the amount of effort put in. Whilst easily obtainable, this is measuring at the wrong end of the stick. One other preferred method is participant surveys, which, depending on whether the respondent believes the questioner has a carrot or a stick, will likely lead to varying responses. These highly biased evaluation tools mislead the evaluation process and prevent the ability to improve. It was this knowledge gap and inability to effectively evaluate its pest management programs that led Western Downs Regional Council to develop a landscape-wide vertebrate pest monitoring program. Operational expenditure of pest management by council exceeded six figures. However, prior to 2014, there was no effective means of identifying whether this public money was having a meaningful impact. We as public servants have an obligation to our community and the environment to tell the truth, even if it's inconvenient. It's not acceptable to stick our heads in the sand and use data sets that just tell positive stories. In 2014, a pilot project was commenced using 10 black flash trail cameras on two mixed cropping and grazing properties north of Dalwi. The premise of seeing whether two different approaches to wild dog management would achieve any significant differences in wild dog activity at these properties. Whilst the data collected over the next 5 years at these sites did not provide any significance in the context of the above question, the significance it did provide was a steep learning curve into landscape scale pest monitoring for our team, as well as the need to further develop a region-wide program to gather baseline pest activity indices for our region. It would have been presumptuous of us as council to assume the data collected from a pilot project from a site that covered under 1% of the 3.8 million hectares of Western Downs provided a true representation of landscape-scale complexities, pest outcomes, and ecological drivers of this diverse landscape. This led to the development of Council's Vertebrate Pest Monitoring Program in 2018, with the aim to get representative baseline pest data across an area with a similar footprint to a European nation. A random stratified sampling design was implemented based on a 22K grid pattern across the region. The sites were selected with criteria of water point with cellular connectivity. Landowner knowledge is used to choose sites that meet the above criteria along with regular pest activity. Through supplemented external funding streams over a two-year period, Council set up 87 of the 93 sampling sites with Enduro 4G trail cameras, a solar unit that supplied indefinite power, and on a 3-metre pole. Each unit was set with the same settings of a motion trigger with a 1-minute delay and a capture period of 24 hours. Our aim was to limit as much bias in the data set as possible, both with camera site placement and camera settings. There is the remaining 5 data points yet to be deployed as we continue to search for solutions to black spot locations and how we remotely transfer data from these sites. Unlike the pilot project, our aim was to automate the whole process of data capture through to data classification and entry. It was realised during the pilot project that the reality of managing the manual data collection and entry of even 10 cameras full time was a significant draw on staff time. For such a program to work, especially at this spatial and temporal scale, the automation of data capture, transfer, classification, and reporting process was required. By using 4G cameras, we have limited our site selection to be those only with enough reception. However, cost savings in not manually collecting data from the field when some sites are a 5-hour round trip for an officer meant that positives outweighed the negatives. The issue remained in the data classification, entry and report generation. Our team recognised early on the potential of neural networks and machine learning to be a solution for managing big data sets. This technology space has come a long way in the past 5 years, particularly with the release of Google's Machine Vision open source software. After looking at multiple options in this space, including a bespoke platform, Council entered a contract with an Australian-based data analytics startup, Evorder. Having already captured 4 years worth of camera data from the pilot project, Council handed over 2.2 terabytes of archived camera images. For our staff, this was roughly about a year's worth of data entry for a single staff member. In comparison, the platform classified the entire set within 4 days, with most of the time being taken up by slow upload speeds and not the model's classification speed. Adopting this fully automated approach has meant that when an animal walks in front of a camera to the point that it is graphed has gone from around 3-month delay to under 30 seconds. This means near live data collection and reporting. Through this reporting, Council can now effectively evaluate our wild dog 1080 baiting programs, coordinated feral pig aerial shooting programs, and identify trends in pest activity indices over the long term. Data collected through this project is not just isolated to invasive species. There is also an ability to automatically classify native fauna species, which gives us the capability to measure how reduction in pest activities can lead to positive outcomes for our native fauna. This means we can properly evaluate whether coordinated pest management throughout the Western Downs is benefiting the environment, which in many cases is a secondary motivator after economic impacts for many land managers. Having localised relevant data on pest activity throughout our region has aided us in better engaging individuals and groups to meet their general biosecurity obligation. Having a tool where a landowner or a group can be notified of current pest activity or have the ability to present large swaths of data in a meaningful format leads to shifting pest management from being reactive to proactive. This switch in management approach means that hopefully action is being taken prior to incidents of economic or environmental loss from pest species.
We've been using the cameras here since 2014, I think. Been successful, I would say, from a management point of view. You know exactly what's coming in, what time they're coming in, and you can deal with them accordingly. You can plan your day or end or night accordingly. If you want to get up at midnight, you know, fair chance that's when they're coming in because the camera said so. You know, you can manage your paddocks too. Like if you've just freshly branded and your little baby calves going back into a paddock where there's known to be dingoes because you've seen them on the camera, obviously you manage that. Don't send them to that paddock or clean the dogs up first. So, yeah, it's been beneficial.
Capturing data over such a broad spatial region does come at a cost. To set up each data sampling point averages around $900 per site, with an ongoing data transfer and data classification cost being around $430 per annum. The use of automation has significantly reduced costs, with the data collection and manual entry being estimated at the equivalent of 2 full-time staff and associated equipment. Return of investment of such a program is hard to calculate due to the complexity of pest impacts. However, knowing the fact that land managers throughout the region are supported in making better decisions around pest management, Council is confident this will lead to better outcomes and lower impacts. It also means that the primary industry has better increased business resilience for future challenges, as well as the intangible benefits on reduced impacts on ecosystems and their services. Along with the benefit of reduced operational costs by automating data management, there is significant benefits in limiting bias from the data set. Throughout the pilot project, there was a total of 8 different staff who assisted in undertaking data classification and entry, each with varying ability in species identification, varying levels of interest in the topic, and depending on the day, varying levels of enthusiasm. This variability creates a data set with ever-changing bias. The benefit of removing the human element out of the laborious task of data entry means that bias becomes uniform across the entire set, thus improving confidence. Whilst the neural network has limitations and varying bias as model accuracy increases, the ability to rerun entire archive data sets through future models in a matter of days eliminates potential bias creep. The Vertebrate neural network currently draws on 90,000 data points to train in its models. It has currently released 5 generations of models, with the latest having an internal validated accuracy of 98.6%. Council's data sets contribute over 15,000 points to this model. Along with fully automated species classification of data sets, there is the ability to manually classify individuals for mark capture recapture studies, tag events such as rainfall, breeding and predation behaviours, all which assists with interpretation of results and cleansing of data manually to correct false positives and negatives. Council regularly generates reports from the dashboard, including activity indices over varying temporal scales, as well as spatial represented data in the form of heat maps. The ability to download CSV reports allows further interpretation of these data sets through trend analysis, percentage of change, and mark capture recapture studies. It is our firm belief that we are only at the beginning of a significant advancement in the capacity of managers and researchers to monitor ecological systems. The days of sitting at a desktop sifting through thousands of false triggers and manually entering them into an Excel sheet are behind us. As neural networks, camera hardware, battery life, and cellular connectivity improve and invariably reduce in price, the excuse to not implement similar systems over regional, state, and national scales disappear. Going forward, our hope is to further expand our program, building on its success and increasing its representation with higher density grid of sampling points. Through this project, Western Downs, its people, environment, and economy is well poised to meet the challenges of invasive species and their impacts now and out to 2051. We hope through sharing our experience with you today, you have been encouraged by the possibility to do so as well.